Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome back to Factorio. My name, of course, is Double Potato. As you can see, in the last episode, we were working heavily on making sure that our copper area was working. Why the heck is there a normal piece of belt down there? That does not make sense to me. And our copper area, our copper stuff, is working moderately, I would say. And I've missed a bit of belt there, so I shall endeavor to replace it. Two bits of belt, that's not acceptable. I suppose we could replace that bit. And these bits, actually. And in fact, this splitter. There we go. Let's replace that splitter. It's not going to make much of a difference, but it should mean that we can just theoretically push out a few more measly wooden circuit boards. Which is all that you can really ask for in life, isn't it? Just to push out a few more measly circuit boards. Yeah, I think so anyway. I think that's perfectly valid. Okay. And one more. Fantastic. Alright, so that should mean that gonna be serviced a little bit better, although I'm doubtful. We'll see. It doesn't really matter. We were eventually working towards creating more of these, although as you can probably imagine, we need a fair amount of iron. Let's actually set this on for 500. I think it's probably completely valid. Alright, where is my robot swarm? Excuse me, where is my robot swarm? This is not a swarm. That's barely anything. Okay, this is more of a swarm. Okay, so currently we're on 300. Okay, so you give me about 100. That was about 100 robots, and this is another 100 robots. Fantastic. I'm okay with that. I think we're gonna work towards some robotic upgrades. Logistics robot speed. Well, we can't do cargo size, but we can do speed. Let's work on speed. Let's do some speed. Not the drug. Okay, I'm just gonna stop. You get the picture. Bring me more robots. Bring me more. Where do they get their iron from? I wonder. They get it from that chest over there. So I'm buffering it. I'm buffering all of the iron in that single chest. Is that iron even? Okay. Yeah. This chest has got a lot of iron in. Okay. Fair enough. Fair enough. Okay, well, this is kind of nice. I'm literally standing next to chest and they're just bringing me all these resources. I feel like a god. It's actually amazing. This is phenomenal. It's beautiful. It's inspirational. Well, it's good. It's good to know that this system is working as well. I mean, their questers don't seem to have a problem with keeping up with demand. What about robot speed 3? No, that's not going to work. Advanced logistics network expander. Oh, what the heck is this? This looks pretty cool. Don't know what it is. Should we build it? I think we could build it. Could we build it? I don't know. But yeah, robots should be traveling like way faster now. What do we want to research? It's been a while since we've researched. What is this? Intelligent chest that equalizes contents with its neighbors. It's alright. I don't know. Lab efficiency. Let's go for some lab efficiency. You know, when you've not got any direct aim, you always go for some lab efficiency stuff, don't you? I think so, anyway. That's good. That's very good. I'm annoyed that we're not managing to pump out more iron gears. I'll be honest with you. I wish we were. That is a failure that I regret. Anyway, we've got some express underground belt. Let's go ahead. In fact, we've got even more. Why isn't it stacking? Why don't you stack? 8 pieces of underground belt. That's 8 entrances and 8 exits. All of which we could speed up. We could speed up this copper stuff that's going on down here. Alright, where are you? Okay. I'm going to go under here. And this will go to there, and this will go to there, and this will go all the way up here, and one more time, all the way up there. Perfect. So now we should have some super, super fast copper. Of course, we're still limited by the fact that we do have a red splitter down there. And we've got occasional pieces of red underground belt along this way. So I think we actually probably want to think about setting up a new splitter area, a new splitter production area, should I say, for blue splitters. I think that would probably be a wise idea. Although, what the hell do I know? What the hell do I know? Alright, well, we're producing our blue track up here. And for a blue splitter, it's even more complicated than a normal splitter. We require a fast splitter. Wow, oh my goodness. I don't even know if I can be bothered, to be honest. I don't even know if I can be bothered. That is just too much of a pain in the ass. I mean, if we wanted to do that, we'd have to automate production for normal fast. So, sorry, if we wanted to do this, then we'd have to do this. And that would mean that we'd have to do this, which is just, it's doable. Oh, it's like easily doable, but it's just, is it worth it? I'm not so sure. I'm really not so sure. So let's just start cracking through these upgrades. Lab efficiency 4, let's do that. I actually do want to tax our system a little bit because we've been producing research flasks for a long, long time, and nothing has really come of it. I mean, if you think about flasks in the system, we've got 2k flasks in literally every chest. Yeah, like almost 2,000 flasks in every chest, and that's only one row. That's not the second row. So in here, we've got, I don't know, like another 10,000 or whatever. So literally, like a third of this chest could deal with the entire demand for blue flasks in this entire piece of research. So, you know, we need to start doing some research, I guess. And if it's lab efficiency, then it can just run on in the background and we don't have to worry about it, which is kind of nice. Green flask production, I mean, green flask production is like, is super chill. I mean, look at this. Look at the old tech that we've got going on at the green area. In fact, you know what? We've still got them being made in bloody assembly machine tier ones. I mean, how would probably be it would be a damn sight faster if we used assembly machine threes or even assembly machine twos, to be honest. But I don't really see the need to do that. I mean, if we can use old tech here and it still works perfectly well, then there's no point in not doing it, I guess. But whatever. Oh my goodness, this chest has been totally emptied. This could probably do with an upgrade, yeah. So that you're making iron gears constantly. You're just producing a little bit faster. Yeah, oh well, whatever. It's fine. As long as we're upgrading our stuff, it doesn't really make much of a difference. Tree farm is looking good. Everything is looking pretty good, actually. I'm just excited about doing some research because it's been a while since we've actually just sat down and said, hey, you know, we're going to crack through some research. Rubber. Why the hell was I making rubber? I was making rubber for something. I know I was making it for something. I'm not completely insane in that I wouldn't make something just because I could. In fact, no, I actually would do that. What am I talking about? I would totally make something if I totally could. While we're waiting for this research to finish, let's go down and try and address the minor issue that we have had with our sorting system. Now, the issue that we had with our sorting system, hop in my car and drive down. Okay. Oh, you kidding me? Really? Okay, well, we'll do a nice, cool reverse technique. Alright, so the issue that we were having and that we are having with our sorting system is that it keeps on getting gunked up by shite, really. So this feedback loop is not great. It's not great. And I think, to be honest, if we're going to do a feedback loop, which I still think is a good option, it just needs to be a shit ton longer. You know what I mean? It just needs to be a real large amount longer. In fact, you know what? We're gonna take this up and that's gonna go in there. Perfect. Alright. We'll see how this works. Oh, goody, goody, goody. Let's get some What do we want? What do we want to get? Advanced tree farming? Not really. I don't want to do anything crazy just yet. Can't get that. Lithium processing, I would love to do, but we're not going to do anything with it. High octane fuel, that sounds pretty cool to be honest, but not yet. Logistics system 1, active provider chest mark 1. Huh. Roboport mark 1? Oh my goodness, we can upgrade this? I did not know this. I am surprised and excited. Let's get some bullet shooting speed. I mean, not like we're ever actually going to need it, but it's worth it, isn't it? It's worth it. Okay, there we go. That's in place. The copper will be able to go round and round and round forever and ever in eternal unhappiness. Okay, let's extend this by one. The reason that I'm extending it by one is just so that we can when sorry. When we eventually decide to do something with these resources, we can just stick it in here. You know, we can just stick this same system that we've got right up here. We don't need to worry about moving this all back by one or whatever. So, quite comfortably, we can do that. All right, great. And let's just use our underground belt that we've just got hanging around. We can just use the old underground belt. There's no real need to use the brand new stuff or the indeed the medium tier stuff. Okay. Like up here perhaps, I guess. All right, something like that. Something like that. That's going to work fine. So if we just eventually try and get it back into the mix, then that should be fine. Obviously, this sorting system is less than perfect because it is really not doing as well as it should. You know, it should be doing a fair bit better than it is, and it's just not picking enough stuff up at a high enough speed. So maybe we could think about upgrading the track. But at the same time, I don't think that would really help anything in the slightest. I'll be honest, I don't think it would help anything at all. We do need to upgrade this here. And a couple little extra bits of belt. There we go. That works just fine. Perfect. Where the hell did I get this belt from? No idea. It's not in construction range. So what I'm going to start doing is I'm just going to start placing random shite down and then just hoping beyond hope that it's within construction range. I should probably keep these on me actually. Okay, I'll take these back actually, thanks. Sorry for the confusion. And the splitter, and then we just get rid of it. There we go. We just get rid of it because the construction robots will do it all. And that is the beauty of having robots do your bidding. It's just fantastic. It's the most amazing thing in the world. But yeah, this system is not perfect, and extending the length of the belt is a very temporary solution at best. I think it is very temporary. Let's speed up the track a little bit, see if that actually does anything. It might actually make the whole thing worse, I'll be honest. In fact, in all honesty, I think it probably does make it worse. But at the same time, it's but yeah, it'll just make it worse. Like, what the hell are we doing? So actually, if we use just the normal tier 1 of belt, if we use like we can use fast belt wherever we damn well please, but if we use the tier 1 belt while it goes in front of the machines, then that should mean that we can pick up literally every scrap of copper. Yeah, that actually works really well, although it sort of slows things down a lot. I don't know. We're looking for that perfect speed, and it seems that fast belt is just too fast. I mean, bits of copper are getting through all the time. Okay, well, okay. Here's the deal. Here's what we're gonna do. Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna have slow downy bits in the middle of this section. And that should mean that occasionally copper will get slowed down on its journey towards the end. And that, theoretically, is the best I've got. Alright? That's just officially the best I've got to deal with this sorting system. And seems to be alright. Seems to be alright. Is that Yeah, right, there we go. That's a bit better. That's a bit more consistent. Yeah, but this seems to actually work remarkably well. It doesn't look like any copper is getting through as of yet, which is exactly what we're after. And if no copper gets through, then I'm going to be a happy guy. I'm so glad this train system is working. I'm so glad that it's paying off as well. It's really nice to see, you know, when a plan comes together. And I love using the trains. I think it's really, really cool. Yeah, so it's just this. Just this bit. Alright, what do we need for one of these? It's just lubricant that we need. Well, what if I did some rough manufacturing process here for... Yeah, what if we did something like this? Alright, what do you need? You need some red fast inserters, which I can make. I'll make 10 of those. You need some iron gears, of which I have 50. So I'll be able to make 5. And you require electronic circuit boards, of which I've got 200, so that's not the issue. It's just gears that you're going to need, I guess. Alright. Well, you know what? It's a start. Giving us 10 super fast inserters is not bad by any stretch of the imagination. However, we are going to need to walk into logistics range, unfortunately. Where's the nearest Roboport? Over there. Let's walk up here and just get some more gears. Because we're going to need more gears to stick into that that assembly machine. Bring me gears. Robots, attend me. Gears, boom, back up to 150. That's 148. That's almost 150. And you want to bring me some more iron as well? I'm not opposed to that. We've got a butt ton of copper, and I don't like it. So what we're going to do is the really cheesy thing of make an iron chest. Stick the iron chest down, stick all copper in, and then delete the chest. There we go. Because I'm an absolute scumbag like that. But you know what? Hashtag no regrets. Literally not one. Good. Very, very good. And we are completely out of lead here. So that is going to stall production of advanced circuits. That is actually really, really bad. Really, really bad. Okay, we need to change things up right now, I guess. We need a Roboport, of which we need 45 electronic circuits for. So let's go and get them, because they're just up here. And we're going to... This is actually going to be a very, very difficult process to come to terms with, because all of our lead supplies are up here, right? So we've got... Not fluorite, that's not the one. Lead, this lead ore, right? So we're going to have to effectively turn all of these into passive provider chests, right? We're going to have a bunch of passive provider chests providing lead to those guys down there, you know the ones that I'm talking about, the ones at the bottom of this line, the ones at the bottom of the furnace line, and they're going to provide lead via requester chests. And that's not my preferred way of doing it, because it's going to require a lot of lead. Let's make some more. Yeah, let's make some more chests. Okay. Perfect. All right, so that just added a whole bunch of new resources to our system. We've got, if I can see, 11,000 lead. That sounds like a lot, and it probably is, in all honesty. But, you know what? I can't help worrying about the fact that we may, you know, that will run out. You know, that's what I'm trying to say. That will definitely run out. There's no point in trying to deny that. We have managed to backlog a fair bit of lead, which is kind of nice, I suppose. Why is this not fast? Should be fast. Let's make it fast. Okay. Great. And our Roboport is going to... We want this to be in logistics range. So, something like that, I guess. That works just fine. Worked just fine there. And that can go there comfortably. And you guys are going to be requesting some of the very, very finest lead ore. Lead ore. Now, where would lead ore be? Problem with a mod pack is that you're just constantly looking. All right, there we go. Lead ore. 200 lead ore is probably a good shout. Right. Great. So all of you guys are set to deliver some lead ore. And also, it means that the robots can now reach me over here, which is great. That's really nice. I'm really happy with that. And we're already seeing shipments of lead ore. Shipments? I don't know. Deliveries of lead ore. Is that lead ore in here? So, have we got more lead ore somewhere else? Probably in the storage chests up in the other half of the base. Whatever the case, this is going to get our lead production back on track, which is very essential. Very, very essential. We did, in fact, need lead for... Well, it doesn't look like we've actually run out of... What's wrong? Yeah, okay, so we did run out of lead. Alright, I get it. It's alright. It's not a problem. Not a huge issue. So what was this making? This is making solder for the electronic circuits. Alright, well each... It makes like 8 solder each time it actually manufactures, so... I don't think, you know, we're gonna be running out of lead anytime soon. That's what I'm trying to say. Also, I think, mister, you've buffered quite enough lead for your entire life. So, maybe chill it on the whole lead thing. Oh, wow. This is gonna be a busy, busy Roboport. A very, very busy Roboport. Because this is going to be a continual process. I don't think it's going to fill up to 200 with too much ease. In fact, I think it's going to be a continual stream of robots that are trying to fill it up to 200, but just not managing. Let me see how my copper system's working. Obviously, this was there before, so I'm not too deterred by that. But I think this whole method of slowing down in the middle using slow pieces of track is actually a totally valid way of doing things. But I think it's great. I'm gonna, you know, say yeah, I think it's amazing. I think it's fantastic. And it all seems to be going pretty well. In fact, you know what? Let's replace at long last the thing that I've been saying I would replace for a while now. This thing. And I just need to pick these out of there. Why did we only make 5? Because we didn't put the other iron gears in. Let's stick this down here. Speed that up. Obviously, it's not going to make a huge difference at the moment, but it will in the future. That's the plan anyway. I will pick this up. Pick this up. You'll finish making that. I'll pick that up. We'll get all the resources, and we'll be out of here. All right. Now, there's just a couple of last things that I would like to do before I end the episode. And that is all to do with, why are we not getting a full saturated belt of copper? Is this a slow piece of belt? It is indeed a slow piece of belt, wow. So speeding that up will actually result in a more consistent copper supply. I mean, look at this. You can clearly see this is not very consistent. And hopefully by speeding it up, yep, there you go. You can see that's a way more consistently filled piece of belt. So yeah, I'm really, really happy that I managed to notice that with my eagle eyes. That's right, you heard me, eagle eyes. That's right. Okay, good. That's going very, very nicely. Very, very nicely indeed. Very smoothly. And it should be getting all the way to the bottom. Theoretically. It's getting mostly to the bottom. It's getting mostly there. But not quite consistently. Let's just take one last look down back at this area and see why it's not getting all the way down. Yeah, so as I predicted, fairly busy Roboport. Alright, so I guess we just don't have enough throughput? Is that it? Is that the problem? Is that really the issue here? I guess it must be. Well, there is something else we could do. Let's try this out for 2 seconds. Underground belt. Here we go. That there and that there. And we sort of just come together in the middle. I know lots of corners and whatnot, but hey ho. That may work as sort of a better way of getting a more consistent stream of iron. But it might not. It might not. That might just be my imagining of things. Alright, great. Let's replace that, because there's really no need for the splitter. Really, no need for the splitter. Well, let's. I know I keep on saying this because I just have no desire to end the episode, but alas, I must have to. Look at these guys trudging back to next nearest Roboport. Is that making a more consistently filled belt? I'm really not sure it is, to be honest. I mean, he's managing to slot pieces in there, so I presume it's not overly saturated. But whatever the case, it's still pretty good. I mean, should be. Yeah, okay, so now we're seeing some pieces get all the way to the bottom, and we've almost got every furnace consistently producing, which is really what we're after. Ladies and gentlemen, my name, of course, has been Opti Potato. Thank you very, very much for watching. Hopefully you'll tune in next time for some more Operation Mega Factory. Until then, bye.